Okay, let's talk about freedom, because in New South Wales it feels really close, I've got to say. But, you know, freedom for the unvaccinated doesn't come until we reach 90% double dose. Gladys Berejiklian has said that will be around the 1st of December. Is that going to happen? We haven't seen this slow down yet, but what are we talking across the country? Is it realistic to get to 90%?
Yeah, so look, the national plan has 70% and 80% as the sort of the triggers for the progressions there. Some of the states and territories are talking about more. But where we are right now, it is possible for us to get to 70% fully vaccinated by the end of October. We think nationally we could get to 80% by the middle of November. And it's also conceivable we could get to 90% around the end of November, start of December. But the factor now is people coming forward. And international experience shows us that once you get past 70%, things do start to slow down. So that's why I'm saying there's still a lot of hard work to do. We can't let people get complacent. We've got to keep our foot on the pedal, and we really need people coming forward and urging others to come forward to help protect all of us and help get us to those numbers which we can get to.
Yeah,
we've got the distribution points. We've got the convenience of access.
Sorry, so what you're saying is for the unvaccinated, you know, they might be hanging out to get to 90% and think, oh, well, they can get away with not getting a vaccine, but that might not happen till well beyond December if that, you know, that tipping point is reached.
Yeah, look, there are people who are unvaccinated now who are still getting around to it. We hope increasing convenience will bring them along. There are some who are still making up their minds, and we also hope to help turn them around, both through education and advertising and the like. But and hopefully friends and peers will encourage them. But there are also people in areas where there are not outbreaks, and this has been another significant factor in some of the complacency. And you know, the thing with Delta is it's going to get to everywhere eventually, and potentially. And when it does, it goes fast. So I really implore people to maintain a sense of urgency around vaccination. I mean, I would not be complacent about vaccination at all. And now that it is getting simpler and simpler to get vaccinated, it's the time to do it, Laura.
Yeah, and we're seeing that in Queensland, aren't we? Because they haven't had a significant outbreak. That might all change within a week.
Mm. Could do, and hopefully, again, we're moving additional supplies and additional points of presence into every area around the country now. So just keep encouraging people, keep turning up.
Okay, what about booster shots? When are those going to be rolled out?
Yeah, well, the Department of Health is developing the policies around that. I mean, the science is still out on boosters, and it's not my primary area of responsibility, but I think there will probably be some options around boosters before the end of the year. Of course, this is about protecting the most vulnerable. So, like with the vaccine program, the first priority will be to those people who need the boosters most to keep them safe. And the science is still being finalised around that, around the world. Mm. But we'll be ready to support with that as soon as we're required to.
And supply, no longer an issue.
The vaccines are coming. Soon we'll have full choice across the country for all of the available vaccines. And AstraZeneca will sort of remain. Pfizer is coming on. Still through an increasing number of GPs, and Moderna, particularly through the pharmacists, who are doing a great job. We've got almost 2,800 pharmacies now across the countryside, and people are turning up in droves, which is great to see.
That is great news. General Frewen, thanks so much for your time, as always.
Thanks, Laura.